Hello there, and thanks for joining me on this particular episode. So we started a series on psychological complexes, and I'd shared four different episodes with you. We started with Introduction to Psychological Complexes, where I talked about what basically psychological complexes are and gave you a brief into what exactly are the types of psychological complexes that we have. In case you missed that video, just check up here and watch. And then in the next episode, I shared with you on inferiority complex, telling you what inferiority complex is, the signs and symptoms, how to detect, and in fact, how to manage, not necessarily treat because you can't treat yourself. I shared that in the second episode. You can also catch up on that up here in case you missed it. And then in the third episode, I talked about superiority complex, what it means, how to detect it, and how to even know that it exists. You can also watch that as well. And the last episode that I shared with you talked about how inferiority complex may be affecting your relationship. And I shared that from a place of concern because I've actually seen people who do the things that they do just because of how they feel or the fear that their inability to measure up with someone is going to affect their relationship. And because of that, they begin to behave in certain ways. Some even come out clearly to say things like, oh, is it because I don't have what you have and all that. Certain statements that people might make in their relationship that already lets you know that, look, this person has some level of inferiority complex. I shared that with you. Now, don't forget that I also shared with you that sometimes when people behave as if they are superior, it's actually because they feel inferior. Now, this is the final episode in this particular series. Ooh, I'm excited because I'm going to be starting a new series or a new topic. I don't know how long it's going to take yet. That has to do with approval addiction. All right, so watch out for it. But for this particular episode, our final episode in the series of psychological complexes, I'm going to wrap up by letting you understand that, look, superiority complexes or inferiority complexes aren't death sentences. The fact that I have shared all this doesn't mean that you are condemned, doesn't mean that you are confined to that particular aspect of your life. All that I try to do sharing these videos or these topics with you is to let you understand yourself better, all right, and not just take things into your hands, but also know that, look, you can be anything you want to be as long as you pay attention to it. And so as much as you pay attention to your physical health, as much as you pay attention to the things around you, what you wear, the things you eat, the things you drink, the places you go to, the people you interact with, your relationship with people, it's also important to pay attention to how you feel within you and how you feel about situations. And I believe that this is what this particular series is going to help you do. Now, there is something called situational narcissism. Now, I came across situational narcissism when I was looking at how superiority complexes can actually affect our marriage. And that is simply our marriages and our relationships, basically. And, you know, if you've heard the word narcissism before, you know what narcissism basically means, you know, and you now merge that with something that is situational, then you realize that it is not just, it's not something that is consistent with a person. It's something that comes around when there is a change in situation. So what is situational narcissism? You know, a situational narcissist is a person who at one time behaved reasonably, but at another time develop some egocentric complex. Now, when you pick the word ego and centrism, you realize that when we talk about egocentric complex, it's that person who believes, who comes up with so much ego, right? So when you have someone who at this point is behaving responsibly, and the next moment the person comes up as someone who has ego, and it shows in how they respond and how they behave, right? You can say that to be situational narcissism, all right? And whether we like it or not, a lot of us find ourselves, a number of people find themselves in that particular phase where they show up situational narcissism. Is this acquired or is it inborn? I bet it is acquired. Now, it is acquired because it can come up in adulthood, not when someone is young, all right? And it shows a whole lot when you're in a relationship with someone, in a relationship, not necessarily a romantic relationship, but in a relationship with someone, and all of a sudden you develop this ego kind of thing where you believe that this person cannot talk to you anyhow or cannot do things with you anyhow, not because you are genuine, but because you feel that you have a level of at some point that you should be respected. Now, so I mean, that's just by the way, right? So I just want you to understand that you may have people who are not always showing extremes of these complexes. So maybe today you think that this person is allowing you to have your way, and then tomorrow this person says no, you cannot have your way, or people give you some feedback. I need to understand that it is not a sentence, and there is no room for stigmatization. Nobody should come and say, look, you have inferiority complex. Nobody should come and say you're suffering from this or suffering from that. No. The key thing here is that you realize who you are. All right, look at these signs and symptoms and check within yourself. Recently, I had a conversation in a WhatsApp group. I was talking about when people say you're proud, where does it come from? A lot of times, it's quick for us to point fingers at people to say you suffer from inferiority complex, or you feel inferior, or you're egocentric, without looking at ourselves deeply. And so before you point at anyone to say that this person has inferiority complex or this person has superiority complex, ask yourself, hope I am not saying this because I want something. Hope I'm not saying this because I feel something. Be very clear that that what you're accusing the other person of is really not something that you yourself are suffering from. And so I hope that you take this along with you, all right, and pay attention to those things and be truthful to yourself, such that when you notice something, you do not sweep it under the carpet or make it seem like someone is not telling you the honest truth, right? Or you think that because the person has behaved in a certain way, then automatically means the person has an ego issue. Maybe the person is inferior, feeling inferior, or the person is feeling superior. Now, let me say before I end this video that there's a difference between feeling inferior and being inferior. And there's a difference between feeling superior and being superior. One is a state of feeling. One is a function of how a person feels. The other one is a state of being, right? I can be superior to someone by level of my position, right? But I may be superior to someone yet feeling inferior. And I may be feeling superior about someone yet I'm inferior to that person. So imagine I have a boss. That boss is superior to me, right? But that boss might be feeling inferior when he or she sees me. It's a function of various things, like I listed in the part of this series I talked about inferiority complex. So there's a difference between your being, your state of being, and your state of feeling, right? So never confuse both of them. Never confuse feeling inferior, superior with being superior and inferior. All right, so thank you very much for sticking with me up to this particular point in time and for actually watching this series. If you have not watched all the episodes, please do catch up. And please help my channel grow. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Share with your friends and family members. Let them also subscribe and watch these videos. It matters to me a lot that you subscribe so you can help my algorithm and cause this video and this channel to reach a larger audience. And I will be back another time. And like I said, my next topic, watch out for it. At approval addiction. Bet you're going to love it. See you next time.